Good day everybody and welcome to another Jarrison Time informational video. In today's video, we will be looking at the integration between Jarrison Time and PaySpace. Once we are in the Jarrison software, we'll start by linking it through to PaySpace. Now with this, we'll click on Setup on our menu bar. We'll go down to Third Party Import, and on our new window here, what we'll be doing is then adding a new option. From there, we'll then start with the third party location, and on the dropdown, we will select PaySpace. Once we've done this, we will insert the needed credentials. In my case here, we have it as then Sky01. We have then our client ID, then as Jarrison_test, and then we go through to our client secret. Now, to get the client secret, what you will have to do is go into the PaySpace software and follow the following steps, which would be clicking on Config, Basic Settings, Integrations, API Credentials, New Credentials, and then completing the necessary fields until you have the actual client secret. Now, in my case, I already do have it, so I will insert that there. After that, we'll go through to the company name. In this case, I'm just going to make it PaySpace Test, just for this. And then we have a few options at the bottom here. So we see the tick boxes that we have. This is for us to be able to import additional information as well that we would want to, that we don't need to set up on our actual field mapping. So in this case, what we'll do is we'll just click on add or update the ID number, and then we'll go through to field mapping. Once we click on field mapping, we will have two columns. The left-hand side will be the column for the Jarrison fields, and the right-hand side will be the PaySpace options. So from here, what we will be doing is linking them. Now, the first one I'm going to link through to organizational group. Second one would be organization position. Then we'll link through the class on to the point for account. And the site we will put onto organization region. The company we'll leave open for this. And we'll put grade to grade, and we'll add the shoe size, then through to shoe size. Now, the extra custom fields that we see here can be fields that you link on top or additionally to here. In my case, I've just done the shoe option. Right, once we have done all of that, what we'll now do is click on save. Once we've clicked on save, we have then set the actual field, so we're going to close that up. We're then going to move over to just have a look at our employees, which is just one employee. After that, we'll go through to import, and we'll go to employees from third party. Now, once we click on this, we'll have our option as our company, as it says, states here, it will say PaySpace Test. Now, should you have multiples, you can always just look through and find the one that you've now created. In my case, there's only one. We're then going to go through to import and have the system start importing from there. Now, with this, the system will go through everything that it needs to process. And here we have it, as we see there, it's now fully loaded. So here we have a pop-up where it is indicating that we have employees that have the same details on the PaySpace side of things. So it's just saying that Jarrison will not just leave them, but just add them with a number 2. Right, so in this case, we can say yes, that is fine. And then our new pop-up tells us that it found 21 employees and imported only 21 of them as well. I'm going to say okay to that. And now on our employee dropdown, we find that all of our employees are loaded as per the setup that we have on our PaySpace. Now that we have our employees imported, we're also going to take a look at then importing leave. So in this case, we're going to go back to setup. We're going to go through to third party import. And this time we're going to go through to our leave tab. Now, once we've clicked on our leave tab, the first thing we'll need to do is enable the actual leave. So we're going to click on that button. And then the system is going to ask us if we want X amount of days going back or days going into the future. Now, this will just make sure that we have the relevant information. Now, in my case, the data that I have is a bit backdated. So I'm just going to put in the maximum amount of 100 days just to make sure I do pick up all of that data. Now, once I've done that, I'm going to click on save again. Then what we'll do is we'll click on the link leave option. And here we will be given all of the leave that we can link, on the left-hand side being now the leave that we have on PaySpace, and the right-hand side this time being what we will be linking from Jarrison's side. Now, in this case, what we're going to be doing is linking, let's say, something like our annual leave through to annual. We're going to go through to our family responsibility, link that also with our family responsibility. We're going to link the sick leave through to sick paid, and we're going to do our unpaid leave through to the option of unpaid leave. Now that we've set all of those leave options, we're going to click on save, and it takes us back to the previous menu. Now, once we're done here, we're going to click on close and then get that leave imported. With that, what we'll do is go through to our menu bar. We'll click on import option at the top left. We'll go through to employees, leave from third party. And in the new window, we will then see our first option is company. Now, again, my company is only the one, the PaySpace test that I set up. If you have multiples, just select the correct one. After which, it gives us a from and a to date. Now, these dates will already be preset per the setup that you've done. So in my case, I'm just going to click import and then have the system load and import that data for me. Now, once we've clicked on the import button, we'll see that the system then starts calculating everything, linking back to PaySpace, and then importing the data for us into the system. Once done, we'll see in a column here, it says 5 adjustments imported. This then means our leave has been imported into the system and we can then go and have a look at it. So we're going to close this window off and then we're going to go and find the employee. In my case, I do know who that employee is. So I'm just going to search for that employee on our search bar here, and this will be that person. Then to see the data, what we're going to do is open our daily summary. We then just have to go and find the information. Now, I do know that in this case, it is in June and it is on the 1st. And here we have it showing us that this employee now has leave on these days. Now, this leave was imported with what we had just done. Now, double clicking on one of them will also show us that the leave has been fully put in and all of the details are set correctly. So we can then close up these two windows now knowing that our leave has also imported. Now that we have completed both the import of the third party normal and the leave third party options, which are both our manual points, we can also do it in an automated point. Through this, what we'll do is we'll click on setup, we'll then click on planned events, and in the new window, we'll set up a automation here. By clicking on add, we'll then on the right hand side change the event type through to one of two options, either a third party leave only or the third party personal and leave. So we're going to then do the personal option with leave. We're then going to select in the third party drop-down option our PaySpace test that we have created. We will then set a time that we want all of this to run. Once the time is set, we'll then go through to the bottom part of it and set up if we want it weekly or monthly. In my case, I'm going to say weekly, and I want this system to import it once every single day. After we've done the setup that we would like, we'll then click on save, and in the new menu that opens up here, the system will just tell us it needs 5 minutes before processing. We'll then click on OK. Once we've clicked on OK, we have now set up the automated point for the system to automatically import that data from PaySpace into Jarrison. So through this, what we'll be doing is then closing the planned events point off. Then as a last point, we can also export this data by clicking on the export icon. And in the new window, we will then see the first option selected is dashboard export employee list. Now the days range we can leave as the current period. And then we have the file path. Now, this file path can be set to be a secured location. You can also use something like FileZilla, but also just set up a secure location on your side and have the Jarrison just drop the file in there for you. If you are then not happy with the C drive or JT data location, then those options are then still available to you. Now, after that, you can also export to decide on a different location each time, or just use the path that you have set. After that, we are then happy with everything. We can close that off, and that will be everything for today's training video. Thank you. Goodbye.